as you are growing up, yeah, there's a lot of temptations young people face. Look at me now, yeah? Look at me now. A lot of temptations. Today, there's a lot of gadgets, a lot of technology, a lot of things that are on the internet, and a lot of stupid things in there that young people do, and they forget God. In the Western world, 12-year-old, 10-year-old, they are all hooked to iPod and iPad and all the eyes. They are hooked to them. So they don't be able to read their Bible and pray anymore because we're in a digital age. And so this thing has distracted them. No one has the time again to pray. Do you know what I'm talking about, young people? Again, they have the youth, they have the zeal, they can run, yeah? They can be able to go. You know, people who are getting old, they take time to walk, yeah, like this, yeah? But young people, they can run, yeah? They can be able to go. So young people, you can pray more. You can fast more. You can read your Bible more. You can lift up Jesus more. You can do this more for God. Woo! Amen! So because of your youthness, you can do more for God in your young age. So what are the things that can separate us from that love of God? The very first thing that can separate you from the love of God is worldliness. Worldliness. The Bible says, don't love the world. Amen. These are the things that are in the world. So many people are not here today. Some people are busy looking for money. Some are busy looking for pleasures. Some are going to Europe looking for an old man to get married so that they can be able to have money. Some are looking for different things in life. Because you know what? The world has captured them. But you're not like that. You're different. You want to serve God. You want to follow God. So the very first thing every young person here must remember is that this world has got a contrary to the word of God. This world is darkness and God is light. So because of that, we don't get attached to this world. In other words, if you have a phone or an iPad, it's not your God. Your God is Jesus. If your phone breaks down, it doesn't mean you don't go to church anymore. Hallelujah. Amen. So what am I saying this afternoon is that the world wants to take our mind away. So many young people today are involved in demonic activities. They follow after Lady Gaga, yeah? They follow after the other one, yeah? And how can you follow after somebody that have a mask on their face and with different, some stupid hairstyle? But the leper, all the music, because of that, many young people today have left their heart to music. If you see Justin Bieber, Justin Bieber. This young 16, 17-year-old boy, they caught him the other day with marijuana. And they detained him in the airport. That's the people that people are looking onto. He's your idol. Your idol is a sinner. Your idol will go to hell. True or false? True. If your idol doesn't repent, they go to hell. So why would you make that person your idol? Only Jesus should be the person I to look onto.
Hallelujah.
But today, young people, they make their idols to be Beyonce, that one, and that one. You know what I find out about all these people? One by one, they will all fail. Because one by one, they cannot live the standard as clear as God's word. That is what the Bible says, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of your faith. Amen. Only Jesus is the only one that can help you. So young people, the very first thing I want to encourage you this afternoon is keep your eyes on Jesus. Amen. Keep your eyes focused on Jesus. Don't let stupid music take you away from God. You know what I really don't like? Can I tell you what I don't like? Some people, they play worldly music and they come to church and play God's music. It doesn't work like that. They play chaka on Saturday and on Sunday, holy, holy. It doesn't work like that. It doesn't work like that. Because what happens is that because of that, you cannot genuinely bring out the glory of God because your music is a different one. Now, can I say this to you? The author of music that is not from God is a devil. Any music that does not glorify God is from where?
Hell.
Yes. So if the music is glorifying the tree, or the lizard, or the idol, it's not from God. So I'm very careful what music I listen to. I want to make sure that every music I listen to comes from God. Because the devil wants to trick our young people into having stupid music in their ear today. So people of abundant, blessed Christ, let us remember that we are carrying the light. Let us remember that in our homes, in our everywhere we go, we should not allow anything to take us away from the light. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
We should remember that God has called us to walk with Him. Because the Bible says, who can separate you from the love of Christ? Worldliness can separate you. If you allow worldliness, it will take you away from God.